Hello everyone, Ceri the Craft here, that's C-E-R-I, the Crafter, and I'm here with a kind of similar video to the one I just launched a few days ago actually. So on June 24th I launched a video for a collaboration stroke launch with Tracy Fox. Great video, loved it, loved what I did in that video. However, it sparked an idea as to use something that I used from a previous collab which I did with Rachel Bella Crafts a little while ago. I want to say it might have been March, I can't remember. I'll link the video anyway, the original video will be down there. However, what happened is I ended up with spare bits of ephemera from a fabulous couple of kits that we were supplied with. One had a load of these little photographs in there, some I printed onto matte photo paper, some I actually just printed onto paper. I think that one's just paper. Actually, those are paper and these are matte photo paper. And there were these little elements as well in it. And I thought, you know what? I want to do something with those. So I thought, using the same sort of theory as I did with Tracy Fox's one, I made a master board. And I'll explain the reason for the dimension of this in a second. So I made a master board, just covered it with some old book pages and covered the back with some pages that can be used for writing for. And I thought, let's make some little journal cards. Now, what I'm going to do is these little journal cards are actually going to be the size of ATCs or artist trading cards. So one dimension is 10 inches because trading cards are 2.5 inches wide. So that gives me 4 that way, and this way is 10.5 inches because trading card dimensions are 2.5 inches by 3.5 inches. So 3.5, 3.5, and 3.5, as far as I'm concerned, gives me 10.5 if I've got the measurements right. So a quick check. Yep, see, you had me doubting myself then, didn't you? So what I'm going to do is I'm keeping it all in this orientation. So I'm going to use this master board and I'm going to use the smaller elements to add stuff onto them. I'm then going to cut them out. I'm then going to sew around each of the individual ones and then we're going to decorate them up using some of these as focal points because they're perfect size for ATCs, artist trading cards, and they would make great little additions that can be tucked into tuck spots in the journal. So other than that, I've just got a glue book, which plenty of room to put that down for once. And I've got my glue stick. I use Pritt stick glue. I tend to be quite heavy with my glue, so I've never really had a problem with it. The only other thing I'm going to be using is I've got like an old store card or loyalty card. This is just to smooth stuff down. Now, as you know, I'm quite horizontal and vertical in my building. I'm going to definitely buy this because remember, it's only small areas. So I'm going to pull out some of these that I really like because I like the blue ones. Now, these are going to be backgrounds for the photographs. So I have to make sure that I don't have things that are miles too dominant. Actually, maybe not. I'll put that one to one side a second. I'm liking these sort of things because the images on them are really, really small. I don't mind if one is repeated because it's a small area. I just want the smallest ones I've got. There you go, there's a smaller one than that. I didn't know they came in that size. Now these have actually got a stamp edge, as in a postal stamp edge around them. I could always cut the postal stamp edge off if I chose. Or choose. Oh, there you go, there's another small one. Let's have a big one and a small one of each, maybe. So this is just a little idea of just way of, I like the little one instead of that, a way of using up some of those little pieces that you sometimes get left. I don't mind a moth is okay. When you actually do something like you cut a kit up and you've got that ephemera and you don't know what to do with it. So I thought this is just a nice little way of just stash building, really. I suppose you could call it a mass make if you wish. I'm just going to create something pretty. Let's have a little look and see if there's anything left in this box that I would use. Half a butterfly. I don't think I want half a butterfly today. There's a little butterfly there. So because ATCs, of course, are 2.5 inches by 3.5 inches, it's always a little bit of a challenge finding stuff that you can use. Right, so let's move that to one side. Now, I also have from the kit these, which if I really want to use any of these, like that's a nice one, that would work. That's probably too big. Not sure I want either of those. So it's just worth sorting through stuff like that's lovely. And I will put that on and I don't mind if it gets cut in half at some point. I don't want too many of these things. I will judge whether I've got too many as I'm gluing the stuff down. But pulling out all of my options are something I like the look of. You can never go wrong with a butterfly, can you? Although those aren't the sort of butterflies I want to use today. I think all of those are big ones. Right, so these are... Okay, there's a stamp-edged one. All I would say to do is just cut off the fluted edge of it, and then that makes it into a little sticker for you. Not a little sticker, a little topper. So there you go, that's that bit done. Now, I need to think, do I want to distress the edges? I might do, actually. Just on a couple of them, like this one, I've just taken the edge off. It could probably benefit with being framed out a little bit, because if you look at it against the background, it's not going to stand out because it's not got an outline. Now, of course, I could always go around with a darker marker to actually make some of the back the edges be framed out. I'm just looking at some of these to make sure that I've got everything done. Now, this shouldn't take me long. I'm not going to be sewing on camera, guys. What I'll do is I will actually stop the video or stop the recording, and then I will come in and sew them and then come back to you once everything is sewn, purely because I find it really annoying if I'm watching a video and someone's sewing and I can't actually see what they're doing, because all the camera is doing is looking at the top of the sewing machine, which is natural. You can't do a lot about that. So let's pull those off to one side and let's start building. I really like this one. So I like all of them, but I really like this one. So just putting on a reasonable coating of glue. And I have to remember, I'm thinking in blocks of about 3.5 and 2.5. I don't want to put lines on here to remind me of those dimensions. However, I do want to bear in mind that there's 4 across and 3 down. And I don't mind if these get cut in half. Any of that is okay with me. I don't mind if they get cut into quarters. There's one piece on one, one piece on another one. Any spare book pages, as you know, go into a container, and that container actually gets used occasionally to make other stuff from. Like I think I make book page pockets, I do book art, I do lots of different things here. I think got about there, I think. So I don't want to get caught up on doing too many big things on here, because obviously the photographs will be going on, but the photographs will be laying over the top of other things. So as I said, remember, this is a background. Try to pull in a few things here. So it's an absolutely stunning day here in Wales. It's just summer has definitely kicked in here, so which I'm quite pleased about, in that I can be quite domestic. I can get my laundry done and get it dried on the line. I know, not a huge concern for everyone else, but I like my laundry dried on the line. What else? I also don't have to wear a coat. I don't like wearing coats. I get a bit, not claustrophobic, but I get a bit, I feel a bit confined when I'm having to wear a coat all the time. And I like being outside, so having the ability to actually not wear a coat and be in the open air are actually really quite endearing to me. But as anyone who's been following me knows, I'm not a huge fan of heat. So the summer is not my friend. In that it's just hot, and well, I wasn't actually able to film yesterday. It was so hot and humid here, there was no way I could be shut in this craft area and doing filming with Well, I just couldn't. It was just too hot. So I just did a few prep stuff for this and prep stuff for other things. So let's pop in there. Obviously, I have no idea where these are going to end up, like in the page itself. I'm beginning to think I need to do some smaller pieces, less bigger pieces. Now, you could, if you really wanted to mass make this and you wanted to be accurate, you could do a pencil line to tell you where the designations are. Then once they're done, erase them and then come in and cut this. But I'm quite happy to wing it, should we say. Is that straight? It is straight. Looks straight to me anyway. Right. Get rid of this before I put things on the top of it. Now, I'm using these little pieces of ephemera from Rachel Bella Craft for making these. You could equally use them as card toppers. You could use them as accent pieces on other tags or other journal cards, pockets, covers, clusters, all and any of the above. That might work in there. I wasn't planning to use all of them, but it seems I'm going to. So I want the moth in there. Which way up does this moth go? Moth goes that way up, right, okay. Now, some of these pieces may never be seen in the final piece. We need to just embrace that because it could be that they're in exactly the spot where I want to stick maybe a photograph. Right. I do want to stick this down. I think I'm going to pop it in there. So this is stage one done. I'm happy about that. Let's just pop that in there. That's enough for the gluing for the second. Put that by a minute. So normally if I was doing something like one of these sheets, I would pretty much make two or three of them because I like to mass make, but we're only doing one today. I thought a short little video. You've had a few really long videos from me recently and I thought, you know what, give you guys a rest, give me a little bit of a rest as well. So right, let's get the guillotine out. I'm a guillotine user, not a trimmer user, so have to bear with me on that. Right. Let's do this very first. So I need these to be 3.5 inches tall. This is where we find out my measurements have all gone wrong. I don't mind if I've got to trim a little bit off. I'd rather have got it right in the first place. And I have got it almost. That's not a bad mistake, is it? So now I'm going to come in and do 2.5 inches in the opposite direction. And I know I could put it in this way and then subtract the number, but my brain works better if I cut it in this direction. So I know there's a quicker and easier way to do this. It's just I like lining this edge up with this groove on the board, on the guillotine board, purely because it means that I've got that straight edge up against that groove. Then I know I'm cutting at a 90 degree angle. Now, once these are done, you could round the corners. There's nothing saying you can't round corners on an artist trading card. And actually, these are going to be mini journal cards for me. So I can do whatever the heck I like, really. And we could even turn some of them into tags. But that would be a decision you would have to make prior to actually sewing them. Let's make sure that last one is 2.5. It's 2.5. Right, let's have a look. So that's a a little look and see what we've come up with. It's like being a dealer in Vegas, isn't it? Ooh, I kind of hoped that was going to do that, so that's good. That's a nice placement of that one. That's nice as well. That's not okay, we've lucked out so far. I haven't chopped anything in two. I've obviously cut a little bit of a butterfly wing off there. That's fine with me. Actually, can I? As it is such a little tiny sliver, I'm going to take it off because I'm going to distress ink the edges of these anyway. See, I don't mind that much of a butterfly being stuck on there, but that little edge would have eventually given me a problem. That's not a problem. That's quite cute. Cute. Am I still in shot? No, I'm not. Push all of these up so you can see all of them. And I don't mind that there's half a butterfly. Would prefer that not to be there. But can I remove it is the question. Is my glue... That's the joy of using a glue stick. I can take that off there. There you go. So that's my basis for stuff. Now, as I said, I wanted to bring some of these pictures in. Now, I like the fact that there's little ones in here, because if I put something that large on, it's just too big. So let's select and do a bit of a flip through while we're here of the photographs, just to pull out the smaller ones. I don't mind that one. Don't know why, some of them I don't mind large, but I prefer they were all small. Yes, if you watch the original video, it will actually tell you what the kit names are. I want to say it was something like Welsh something, Welsh Ephemera or Welsh Memories or Family something Welsh. It's in the link. You'll find it. I'll put the right title in, I'll put the right link in. In the previous video, it's already there. So let's have a little look, see who I want where. He looks a bit studious, doesn't he? Maybe he can go there. This is the one I didn't mind, this one, did I? I think this is just marginally too big for me. I think if I look at this, there are lines on here from obviously where the original picture was mounted. So I'm just going to trim it down to that line. There, that's a bit bigger. So I don't mind that there. Right, a schoolboy, I don't know that he's going to be... He could be someone that collects butterflies or... But he looks like a rugby player, so we're not putting him on there. Don't like that one. It's a bit similar to the background. No. Don't mind her. Oh, plane going overhead. Now, it could be that not all of these are going to cut that one down. Let's put the smaller size on. We can live to be another day. It could be that on the others I put butterflies or something, or I'm not sure. Quite like that because it's got the green on it. Let's put you on there, lady. Right, so we've got those on there. Do I want to put anything else on there before I stick them down? Right, I think I'm going to distress ink the edges. Not that I always do that, but I think in this case it would actually benefit them because it will it will frame them out a bit. I think that's how Gales mentions it, Gail Augustinelli. I've heard Tim Holtz, I believe, say that as well. It frames the piece out. So, right, let's glue those ones down. Oh, get the glue stick open. Now, I tend not to use things like art glitter glue and Fabri-Tac to stick down photographs, because I have an experience in one of my own journals. It was my Harry Potter journal, and I stuck the photographs down with, I believe, like it was one of those two glues. I can't for 100% remember which one. And when I've opened the journal recently, the photographs have been affected by the glue that was at the back of them. So just be a little cautious of that. It's not something I actually thought about when I stuck them down. So my bad, I should have thought about that. If anything, I probably should have put them down with double-sided tape. I think that might have been a little wiser. Or glue stick will work, but sometimes because glue sticks, because photographs have a shiny surface to them, sometimes a glue stick isn't always the best option. I suppose I could always glue stick it down then sew around it, but that doesn't feel like something I want to do today. I'm already sewing around the outside edge anyway. So that started them. Right, let's see. Now I did also have words, so I can put words on them later if I choose to. I mean, I'm not sure that I will. I might or might not do, but now I'm going to dip into, let's see, what else have I got that I could put onto these? I've got some washi stuff, which would be in a theme. That's a bit big for that one. I've just bought these too. I've never used these before. I found these on Etsy. They're little books of stickers. As I said, I've never used them before, so I'm unsure. Let's give this a go, shall we? Let's put it on this one. Okay, that's a good thing. It comes off easy enough. I'm going to put glue on the back of it because I never trust anything that's got the word washi in, as far as I'm concerned, gets a good helping of glue. Is that straight? It is now. Okay, it's a bit transparent, but that's not bad. It looks like it needs a focal point on it. Okay, those are all right then. Let's see what else we've got over here. I wonder whether I've got a small bird or something. Because a bird would be quite nature, wouldn't it? Trouble is finding a bird that's small enough that makes sense for these. I don't mind that one. Let's hold that out for a second. There may be others that I find. I quite like the ones that are in flight, and I quite like those two. Oh, what's this one? Thinking about those. So I'm just fussing my way through. Oh, there's an owl. I like owls. Actually, I like him on there. Right, so I've got birds on that one. I think I'm going to leave it and have... Oh, he's nice. Oh, and he's almost the perfect size. I think I'll stick with that one, and I did quite like this one. I don't know why I like him flying out of the picture. That's not normally the sort of thing I do. Right, these will need a little distress around the edge just to clean up some of that whiteness from the fussy cutting. I think I've either got these birds in Happy Mail or I ordered them on Etsy somewhere. And sometimes I do order fussy cuts from other suppliers, because to be honest with you, I don't always have the time to fussy cut. I mean, I don't mind fussy cutting. I mean, I do fussy cut. Not my favourite pastime. I'd rather spend a pound or two getting someone else's fussy cuts and use that time for myself than actually sit there fussy cutting away like a mad fool. I can see we're going to need some labels on these at some point. Right, so let's take out of the picture the ones have been done. Just trying to work out which ones need to be out of my eyesight. Right, so these five, are we all on screen? These are okay, they need more, but currently they're okay. These need a something. Oh, we can use some of these. Okay, butterfly labels. I like these. Okay, basically, well, there's biscuit in a very high volume. These were book page, and what I did is I stuck washi butterflies onto them. Some of them are actually napkin butterflies. When the butterfly was singing, the maple leaf just fell on its head. After summer, it's autumn. Okay, don't understand quite why that says that, but I like that on there, actually. So, yes, please don't ask me where I got them from. They are a mixture of several different things. Is that one done? I do like these. So I'll find another one I really like. Pink one. Actually, this blue one is reminiscent of that blue one, but it covers up too much. No, let's not do any more of those. So we can always use postage stamps. That's another thing that's a good size for artist trading cards. Like something with flowers or butterflies or insects on it, to be honest. Are there any with that? Yes, I think these are the ones I'm looking for. It's a nice little cute one. You know me by now, I'm all about loads and loads of layers. Feel I like that one, I haven't found the right one for it yet. So hopefully you can just about see what I'm looking through here. Where do I buy my stamps from? I buy them from wherever I can find them. There was another one with an owl on it. A lot of the time I will get them on eBay, and what I'll do is I'll do a search for... Actually, is that the one I like better? No. I'll do a search for photo albums or stamp albums or stamp collections, and then I'll bid on them. I don't usually bid a lot of money on them because, to be honest, they're just boosting my supplies. But I will do an auction, and sometimes I win, and sometimes I end up. And when the photo album or the box of photos come through, it's a really nice collection. Sometimes they're just run-of-the-mill stamps, but I can always use stamps. I quite like that one for there, actually. Right, I think... Let's pull that one out as well. Right, let's leave these on side. Now, I'm not going to go around the edges with distress ink on those. I'm just going to stick these down because they're quite near the edges of the artist trading card in the first place. And that usually means that the stitching is going to outline them slightly. So that one we can call done-ish. This is the one I wanted to put on here. Oh, sticky, sticky. Another thing I do too is, I don't know in the country where you live whether you have things like car boot sales. A car boot sale is basically where, oh gosh, what would you say? It's a bit like a garage sale, but a car boot. It's in the trunk of a car. So what someone would be doing is they'd be clearing out some old items from their house. There's usually an event maybe once a month at maybe a park or a parking lot or something like that. And people would drive up. They would pay a little money to hire the spot where they're going to park their car. And then people can have a wander around, and if there's something they like the look of, they'll just buy it. So we have those in the UK. I like that one there. I know I'm covering up our baby butterfly, but I did say some things could get covered up. So I like going to those as well. It's a bit like an estate sale. If you're in the States, you may be aware of estate sales. Very rarely do you find new items there. Very often you find some very old items there. But has everything got something on? Right, I think we're at the point now where I just want to put some labels on these. And I think I'm going to reach for my Tracy Fox labels, the labels I normally use, which are these ones. Now, obviously, you could use tickets, you could use numbers, you could use anything like that. I mean, absolutely anything at all that you like. So, right, let's just work on these one at a time, because this will be the finishing touch for me. And I think each of them is going to get a label, and that's it. Now, the labels here are, as I said, Tracy Fox labels. They're a combination of a couple of different kits. So in one there may be field notes, there one may be random labels, but I would say go and have a look at Tracy Fox. Tracy Fox on Etsy is Love Junk Journals. She has a lot, and I mean a lot, of very high quality digitals. And that's pretty much where I get, if I don't make my own labels, that's where my labels come from. And the joy of a digital, of course, is you buy it once, you can cut it and print it as many times as you want. And I love that. Excuse my dirty fingers, it's the glue, I promise you. I'm not really reading the labels or examining the labels. I'm concerned that the labels are the right size. That's the driving force for my selection of them here. Now, of course, you could use washi on these. You could use anything else you like, really. You could stamp onto these. Right, this one's a bit bigger, doesn't it? Red foxes. I don't think that's the right one. That will work, that. I always have lots of people asking me, how do you know where to put stuff? I would say it's trial and error, really. I would say I do a lot of this stuff. I do quite a bit of collage. I watch a lot of other people making collage and making ephemera. And I think what you do is you build up a mental library of stuff. I'm looking at this thinking, would that be cute? It's too big. Unfortunately, just a little bit too big. looks a little duplicate. Anyway, right, let's have a keep on this side. This side seems to have more options for me. Let's do that way, because a little vertical is not going to kill it, is it? So, yes, so it's all a case of just having a go, guys. The more you watch other people do it, the more you're going to absorb a mental catalogue of how to create stuff like this with layers. Also, the more you do it yourself, the more you will eventually find your style, your way, your actual confidence in just sticking it down. I think for me, the biggest problem when I first started was I didn't want to make a mistake. I wanted to always do it correctly. And what that did is it just stifled my creativity, because then I never did anything just in case I might do it wrong. And then one day I came to this moment where I just went, you know what? No one really gives a damn. The only person concerned about it is me. Art is basically art. You can do what you want, when you want, wherever you want, however you want. If you don't like my art, then just don't look at it. It's hard, though. You've got to be incredibly brave to put your work out there for potentially the entire planet to see. I wonder whether he wants a blue one. That looks a little bit too big. It's hard. I mean, everything you do is in the public eye. If you choose to put it into the public eye. I think I want that one in there. So whether you are Picasso, Van Gogh, your Aunt Mabel, anybody, whatever you put out there, there is always going to be someone who loves it, and there's always going to be someone who thinks they have the right to have an opinion to tell you how to do it properly. But you know what? Just ignore those people. You're doing your art for yourself. And I think if you purposely create anything, whether it's a greetings card for someone in your family, to a journal for yourself, to anything, everything is art. So I think we're all artists and we all work, all march to our own drummer, should we say, which I think is a lovely thing to think. Right, this one needs quite a substantial label on it. I'm actually thinking of covering that up totally, because it's lost under there. And I think something along those lines, or if I place that, I could just about cover up the fact that there's something rectangular underneath it. So let's just do the edges. So yes, and that of course is my opinion, and my opinion only. I'm not quoting anybody or anything, and I'm certainly not intending to insult anybody. However, when I realised that the person I had to please was me, I suddenly started viewing stuff slightly differently. I suddenly became, what's the word I'm looking for? A little less concerned about what I created, as long as it pleased me. Does that sound selfish to anyone? It shouldn't sound selfish to anyone. I also needed to remember the reason I create. It's brilliant for my mental health. It calms me down. It's my happy place. I have a very busy life. Being able to actually just create something just absolutely is a gift. And I so appreciate that gift every single time. I never take for granted that I've been given something and the ability and the imagination to create something. And I know I'm so blessed by that. That's the one that room in there. And it was a gift given to me for me to cope with life. That's sort of how I view my creativity. And hopefully you will as well. Right, these are pretty much, besides sewing them and going around the edges, they're pretty much done. Now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause this video. It'll be 2 seconds pause for you. It'll probably be considerable minutes for me because I have to sew around every single one of these with my sewing machine. I'm going to go around them, I think, in brown, a brown thread. And then what I'll do is I'll also off screen, I will use my distress ink and go around the edges with them as well. And then we'll take a new look at them to see whether they need anything else, which if they needed anything, it might be a small number. So here I'm back again. They've all now been sewn around and I've distress inked around the edges. So I think some of these will need numbers. So we'll do that next. But let's take a look and see what we've got. So I quite like these. This one might need a little something there or even a little something there. I'm not sure. But we'll go through them as each one of them in turn. And I must remember to hold them up. Even though you do know, guys, if you're on a device, if you touch the screen with two fingers and pull it apart, it will actually zoom into YouTube, a video, if you're on a smart device, I believe. So obviously not on a computer. So see, this one needs something else on it. This one may not need something else on it. Still not overly happy with this one. It's okay, but maybe when I put something on there, it'll pop out. I really like that one. Right. So I'm going to use art glitter glue for this, and I've got some of these little numbers here. Now, I don't know whether they're Tim Holtz numbers or whether they're from another kit or something. I don't know. Or maybe they were just in like an ephemera pack when it arrived in. So I'm just going to take all of these out of here. It'd be far easier for me to look through them if I can actually see them in front of me, all facing the right way up. Now, some of them may be too big. Some of them I may actually cannibalise and shrink down a bit. Some of them may not need it at all. So let's just start with this one. So right, I do think this needs something there. Or it could do with something up there. So let's have a little look at this. Nope, I'm thinking of something to pull in some colour, to be honest, on this one. Oh, there's purple on that. Actually, I think if I put that up there, I'm going to trim down the very edge of this, bear with me. I've just cut off the ends of this just so it's ever so slightly smaller in length, because I want it to go in here and I want it to pop in up there. So I think I'm just going to get my distress ink. I'm just going to put a little bit around on it so that it isn't so stark on the background. As I said, I'm going to use art glitter glue because it's cardstock. And also it grabs really quickly, so it means that once it's done, it's done. Right, we'll look at them all one more time when I've finished. So let's see this one. Now there's some blue in here. I do think it needs something down there. I would quite like to have something round, to be honest. I don't think I've got anything round. This feels like it needs a round thing. Tracy Fox did used to have some little round ones or oval ones. I might have used them. Let's put that on there. Now, a lot of the time when I'm doing ephemera like this, I will actually not finish it until I'm working on the journal. Because that way I know if there's a theme, I could tie something from the theme into this. I just realised it says specimen twice. We will have to live with that. Right, this one. It wants something really small. Maybe that's okay, actually. I'm going to leave that one. Not everything needs a label. Quite like this because it's got some green in it. What's that little itsy bitsy one? That's in the wrong place anyway, so. I don't mind vertical. I don't like the word copyright there. I mean, if it's not jumping out to me, then maybe it doesn't need something. Actually, I like to slim that down, such as snip that off there. I know it's really, really narrow. However, it's just the tiniest bit of something up there that will add to detail. There you go, you hardly see it amongst the text, but we know it's there. Right, this one I'm going to leave to last because this one needs something. I can't work out what it is yet. This one looks like it needs something there. Now, where's that square one? I had a square one earlier on. Is that it? Is that a label? It feels like a sticker. Are you a sticker? Okay, if you're that hardy, you're not going to be used. Okay, no tolerance for that today. It's too warm, it's too humid, and I'm not bothering with that. Especially when I've got one that looks like it might work anyway. I wonder. This keeps catching my eye. I think the blue stands out a bit too much. But pink and lilac go together really well. Maybe I don't need all of this. Let's pop that down there. If I had to cut that square, it would have been better, wouldn't it? I'm terrible for cutting wrong. No, that wasn't it. Ooh, that looks cute. That's the one. Isn't it funny? You know it the moment you see it. Well, I think you know it the moment you see it. Not everyone does, but if you listen to your gut instinct, usually you can tell the moment it's the right one. It just is right. Right, we'll come back to those. This one, I don't think that needs anything. It's got enough on it. This is the one I really did think it needed something, possibly along the top. That's the one. And of course, any of these labels you can interpret in any way, shape or form you wish. Now you could go here and here, but then that's really is overkill on that. Okay, I was looking at this earlier on and it bothers me slightly that that's the slight angle, a slight angle there. I don't think I'm going to be able to correct it completely. I mean, I put that down the bottom, that could possibly correct the bottom, although this label doesn't look straight for a start. No, that's not, that one isn't working for me. Yeah, it's just this, just maybe that would actually just straighten the bottom edge up. We'll have to think and see if there's anything I can do with the top. If not, sometimes it is what it is. I mean, we're all artists. We're all creating unique pieces. We're human beings. I'm going to bring this down so I can see it. I know I'm off screen, but it's important I get this level. There you go. So that's leveled up the bottom of the picture. Quite like something up there, though. See, I think something across the top it's going to be a little bit too much, but as if I did what I did with the owl and make it quite thin, I should be able to get away with it. So just give this a little smidge of the vintage photo. To be honest with you, I'm probably getting more on my fingertips than I am actually on everything else. Right, gently try and line this up with the edge of the card and not the edge of the photograph. There you go. Can't do anything about the sides, don't intend to do anything about the sides. This one I think should be classed as done. I think if I put anything else on there, it might look a little weird. Like, the only thing you could potentially do, I'll pull one of these out, is put something there, but then it looks like it'd be too much. Again, I think that's done. I think I want something down there. What are these ones that are upside down? Oh, actually, that works for me, just a plain number. I'm really happy. I've just treated myself. Not something I do that often. And I bought myself a new stamp set by Tim Holtz. I'll show it to you in a second. Let me get this on there if I get glued in. There you go, that's pressed down. So I've just bought myself. It's a major treat. It's certainly not a cheap set. Field Notes CMS 396. I know it's been out quite a while. I know other people have already got it, but it's a considered purchase as far as I'm concerned. And I bought this because look at all the different numbers and things. So what I do is I save the edges. Say this is an old book page. I would tear this strip off and then I would stamp on it and make my own little stamps. And I'm running low on numbered stamps. So I'm going away on a retreat. Actually, I'm on a retreat. You're watching this. I think this is my very first day of the retreat. And I'm going to take this with me. I'm going to spend maybe one evening and just sit down and stamp out all these little numbers. And then they'll become labels. So I love that. Yes, Mr. Holtz, you are a little expensive, but value for money, I think. I will use that for a very long time. So I think we're done with that. Let me just have a little second here to clear the decks. And I just want to look at this one. Now this one is bothering me. I don't really know what I want to do with it. It needs something. I'm just trying to get hold of this ticket here. Whatever I do is going to cover up that flower. Except that doesn't, does it? Let's put it by there. I wasn't planning on doing it down there. I'm not keen on this one. I mean, all of the others I think are fine. This one struggled with loving it. So, sorry about that, Mr. Artist Trading Card, but you're not my favourite. I wonder whether I had just a little something there. See, I think it just looks a bit too much. Now, leave it as it is. It can go in. Maybe I'll find a postage stamp or something later on that will fit there and will look correct. Right, let's have a little tidy up and then I think we're done. Let's push those to the side. You don't need to look at all my mess. So let's have a little look through and see what we've produced from basically scraps and little bits of ephemera from a kit that I may not otherwise have used because they're really small. So that's the one I'm not overly keen on, as I said. Quite like that one, but then I really do like ferns. Like that, like the boldness of the pink in that one. Like this, this is very me. I like this one a lot. Yep. I just thought this one could do with a little Tim Holtz person on it, but I don't actually think I've got a Tim Holtz person that small. There you go. Like this, I like the way that these butterflies follow into that butterfly. purple. That's almost purple. I think that was a print error. I think I was running out of print ink and it turned purple. Love this one, but I like owls. Anyway, I like this. That speaks to me. Blue, one of my favourite colours. I didn't like the fact that I had... Ooh, that's an idea. What about if I put a label over the top of that label? Oh, bear with me. We might be having a moment, guys. And actually, look at that. There's a blue one. Cut that down just ever so fractionally. Talk about squirrels in the studio, I tell you. Right. Around the edges there. Sorry, this is like the song that never ends, isn't it? But it was bothering me that I had the word specimen twice. And I think that is just enough to finish that off. I'm okay with that. And then our final one was this one. Think, guys, let's just line these up so you can actually see them fully on the screen. I think that's going to be the end of the project, to be honest with you. I think it looks fine. I think that's used up some scraps. It's used up some bits of ephemera, used up a piece of cardstock that was going begging. I used up some coffee dye papers to back these with. I used some old loo pages to put down. I think that's a job well done. Those will go really nicely in my stash. I'm not going to put them with my artist trading cards because I fully intended them to be small journal cards so they can just slot into a little pocket or a tuck spot. But you never know. If I'm doing an artist trading card swap at some point, I might delve into these as well. So thank you for your patience with my dithering. I'm Ceri the Crafter. That's C-E-R-I the Crafter. I'll tell you next time. Bye-bye now.